Sir Roger Bannister was the first person to break the 4-minute mile by turning a time of 3 minutes 59.4 seconds in 1954. Subtract 16 years and you'll find a track star by the name of Louis Zamperini should have been the first to crack what was considered impossible in those days. Louis' fantastic tale is told in Lauren Hildebrand's book, Unbroken, a World War II story of survival, resilience, and redemption. In 1938, word was getting around that Louis just might capture the ever-elusive record. His competition at the NCAA championships was not too keen on that. So under orders from their coaches, some runners sharpened their spikes to cut into Louis during the race. They surrounded the star to prevent him from breaking away from the pack. The notion of sportsmanship was lost on those who were willing to jam their shoes into Zamperini's shins, stab him in the foot with a spike, and crack a rib with an elbow. Amazingly, he managed to break through the mob that encircled him and just missed the mark by barely over 8 seconds. Considering that he was assaulted by the crowd that contained him for a lap and a half, Louis would have crossed the finish line in under 4 had he not had to escape his attackers. As you can tell from the title, Louis' destiny lay elsewhere when war came calling. Who wouldn't be appalled by such an injustice? How many of us would commit such an affront to fairness to win a race? Is that the height of our standards, though? That we stop short of physically gouging our fellow man while in pursuit of our precious ideals? In 1805, John Adams wrote the following in a letter to Benjamin Rush, a friend and fellow signer of the Declaration of Independence. Our electioneering racers have started for the prize, such a whipping and spurring and huzzing. Oh, what rare sport it will be. Through thick and thin, through mire and dirt, through bogs and fens and sloughs, dashing and splashing and crying out, the devil take the hindmost. How long will it be possible that honor, truth, or virtue should be respected among a people who are engaged in such a quick and perpetual succession of such profligate collisions and conflicts? This concludes the Trayvon Travesty, a saga of self-deception. My name is Richard W. Memmer, and I would like to thank my panel members for being such good sports. My profound gratitude also goes out to a number of others who helped me put the polish on my program. Many thanks to Shane Killian of skmedia.org for his film work and delivering such top-notch video editing with exceptional ingenuity and extraordinary instincts. I would like to give a very special thanks to Professor Houston Wood at the University of Virginia, David Albright at the Institute for Science and International Security, and Greg Thielman at the Arms Control Association. Their contributions to this subject matter cannot possibly be overstated. They were very gracious in entertaining my barrage of questions. I'd also like to express my appreciation to all the writers who never let up in pursuit of the story behind the story. And I take my hat off to all those who helped them uncover the truth in the face of so many dead set on concealing it. As M. Scott Peck put it, mental health is an ongoing process of dedication to reality at all cost. I couldn't agree more. Thank you for watching.
The old man turned off the radio, said, where did all of the old songs go? Kids sure play funny music these days, and they play it in the strangest ways. Said, it looks to me like they've all gone wild. It was peaceful back when I was a child. Well, man, could it be that the girls and boys are trying to be heard above your noise? And the lonely voice of youth cries, what is truth? A little boy of 3 sitting on the floor looks up and says, Daddy, what is war? Son, that's when people fight and die. A little boy of 3 says, Daddy, why? Young man of 17 in Sunday school, being taught the golden rule. And by the time another year's gone around, it may be his turn to lay his life down. Can you blame the voice of youth for asking, what is truth? Young man sitting on the witness stand, the man with the book says, raise your hand. Repeat after me, I solemnly swear. The man looked down at his long hair, and although the young man solemnly swore, nobody seemed to hear anymore. And it didn't really matter if the truth was there. It was the cut of his clothes and the length of his hair. And the lonely voice of youth cries, what is truth? Young girl dancing to the latest beat has found new ways to move her feet. A young man speaking in the city square is trying to tell somebody that he cares. Yeah, the ones that you're calling wild are gonna be the leaders in a little while. This old world's waking to a newborn day, and I solemnly swear that it'll be their way. You better help that voice of you find what is truth, and the lonely voice of you cries, what is truth?